Hey YouTube friends. So, continuing on with my crystal memorization series, thought tonight I would talk about sodalite, or as I like to refer to it, socialite. It's a nice little stone that helps you get through social situations. When you work with sodalite, or when I work with sodalite, like I said, I do tend to call it socialite, because this little stone can help me walk into any room, any situation, and be confident enough to be myself, to rely on my own ideas, my own belief system, and not have any fear of judgment. But I still, like anybody else, I want to be accepted in those situations. So I always go into them worrying how I'm going to come across to other people. But when I work with sodalite, before I go into that situation, I take the worry out of it, and I just feel grounded and secure enough to be myself, but to go into a situation with a totally open mind. It removes all my blockages. Doesn't remove all my fears, but it does remove all my blockages and allows me to consider objectivity. Now, I do tend to set up a bit of a ritual, like I always do with a lot of my stones. I have to be completely grounded. I love to use this little marvelous little statuette that shows an interconnection of people, because that's what sodalite is for, or socialite as I call it. It's this beautiful little blue stone. It's almost always blue, or blue and white, blue, white, and gray in my case. I love the way that this one feels in my hands. It's normally tumbled. It's very readily available. The scent that I like to use is sweetgrass, because that is the scent that just says me. It's grass. It comes from straight from our earth. It's what you can go outside and stand on. Sweetgrass especially is an amazingly high vibrational grass, and a very grounding grass. So I do tend to use that when I work with sodalite, because when I go into a situation, I want to be completely grounded, completely secure in myself. And then, like I said, I'll use this little statue, and I tend to inscribe on these little tea lights just any little thing that I want to accomplish that day or that evening in that social situation. I'll just inscribe a word or a symbol, and then that's what I'm going to drop into my little statuette. But you can do this in any way that's comfortable for you. I get completely grounded before I go into that, because I know I'm going to be dealing with people. And I want to interject myself into that room, into that group. And I want to go into it without making any excuses and few expectations, but I don't want to have the fear of being myself. I want to feel like I can go into that room, whether I'm accepted or not. My self-esteem is very high, and I go in there thinking, I'm just going to feel free to be me. And I'm not going to worry about the judgments. And That's what sodalite does. That's what sodalite does for me. It's a socialite stone. It helps you interconnect with other people with very high objectivity, a very free mind and open mind, and not worrying about judgment or repercussions. But before I use it, I make sure that I'm completely grounded and that I'm sure of all my expectations. I don't set them too high, but then I don't fear that I'll be rejected. So this is great for if you have to go into your job for a meeting, or if you're on the first day or two of a new job, or if you're going into a family situation, or if you're meeting somebody's new family for the first time, if you're going to a party and you're afraid you're not going to know anybody there, then try connecting with your sodalite before you go. But I highly recommend getting completely grounded first. Get grounded. Ground yourself. Inscribe some words of encouragement to yourself, or some expectation, something you want to accomplish that evening. And don't be afraid to be yourself. And just thoroughly enjoy your sodalite, or as I like to call it again, your socialite. Okay, guys, many blessings. Ta-ta.